Good afternoon, everyone. So, I'll be delivering the presentation on sanitary drainage, and we will be making it very interactive. So, aap ka dimag khula rakhe baithiye. I will be asking you a few questions, and if you don't answer the common questions, it would be embarrassed. So, please be attentive. It's a very interesting and one of the heart of the plumbing system topics. So be attentive. Second, as you must be aware, there will be questionnaire quiz after this. So you have to understand the things in detail. If you have any doubt, don't wait for the session to end. Just raise your hand and I will allow you to speak. Okay? So we'll be starting. So the topic is sanitary drainage. So we can see here, it is about the draining system, sewer and stormwater. The sanitary drainage provides means a conveyance of sewage as a liquid waste from the plumbing fixture to a public sewer or private sewer. Provision in the code regulation, the design, construction, installation and quality of material for drainage system in order to protect the public health. In general, the content of the chapter refers to Uniform Illustrated Plumbing Code and NBC 2016. So, before starting, I will make you aware quickly about the seriousness of the topic. This analogy I give to all my clients, friends and those who are relevant. In a house, if you are living in a house, you can survive if there is no electricity for some time. If there is no water, you can probably bring the water in the containers. If there is no AC, you can sweat but you can still survive in the house. But if there is a problem with your drainage, you will get shattered. You will find someone to screw up or you will find someone to fix up. So everything else can be arranged, adjusted, but if sewer is there, you cannot wait. You want the things to be cleaned up quite quickly. Okay, so this is very serious topic, one of the heart of the plumbing subject. So let us start with this. There are several codes. These are two codes which encompasses all other codes. So there could be IS 4985, 15322. There are several codes on plumbing. Okay. SP35 is one of the special publication plumbing edition, but these two code encompasses the practical as well as theoretical guidelines for designing the plumbing system. Majorityly, one pipe fully vented system has been covered in the UIPC, that is Uniform Illustrated Plumbing Code, and two pipe system with venting, which is extensively followed in India as well as covered in NBC 2016. Now there is some part available in the for the one pipe system in NBC 2016 also. I will try to run quite fast because we have 1 hour and 90 slides I have to cover. Multiple options are available in building sanitary drainage systems such as one pipe partially vented, one pipe fully vented, two pipe system, single stack system. Now I will not elaborate it here because there are slides which are good presentable slides next for each of the system. One pipe partially vented system. Now these slides will be with you, so I will not go much into the text part, but I will try to explain you the system so that you understand the crux of matter. So what is the meaning one pipe partially vented system? So it simply tells that the soil and the waste pipe from within the toilet are connected to a single vertical stack. The vertical pipe are also called as stack, okay, inside the shaft. So you can see there is a single pipe which is acting as a vent also, and WC and bath or kitchen are connected to the single pipe. So the outcome come from the WC is usually called as black water, and the outcome from kitchen and the bath is called as grey water. Okay, so when grey and black is combined, it is called as one pipe system, but there is a vent, so it is partially vented. It is not fully vented because the pipe is serving both the purpose. One pipe fully vented system. So you can see there is a separate vent derived which is going up to from the fixtures. Okay. Then there are multiple other things also available. Individual fixture vent, common vent. There are multiple typologies are also there, but we are not going to cover that here. Okay, we will cover the single and double with vents. So now you can see the soil and waste, gray and black, is coming to single stack, but there is a vent. It is as simple as that. Then two pipe system. So what could be the meaning of interpretation of two pipe system? Gray is separate, black is separate. The waste from kitchen and bathroom is separate and WC is separate. Okay? When you give them the common vent, this is two pipe system with vent. Two pipe system with common vent. As I said, you can see the common venting here. And this is independent vent system. So soil also has vent and waste also has vent. Now, two pipe system with common vent, I have already explained you this and this also. Now, why to provide separate vent and why to provide the common vent? There are criteria. In National Building Code of India 2016 version, there is a page given with the fixture unit, height of building and vent sizing. So, you can find over there, for a particular small height of building, probably 2 floor or 3 floor, there is no vent required for certain fixture units. But if it is a mall or a public place like theater, something where the urinals are more, WCs are connected in the array, over there the venting is provided because the fixture units are very high. So based on that, the venting system can be designed. If the building is tall and your single vent is size is going, let us say, beyond 150 or 200, then it is advisable that you go for the double venting system. So we covered this single stack system. So what is the single stack? As I explained you, you can see here from WC, it is connected to the one pipe which is installed in the stack or shaft, then wash basin, then floor traps. Connected everything to the one down tank. The stack is also called as down tank. Okay. So you have to be habituated with these terminologies, otherwise it won't make sense. When we talk about phones, we talk about particular terminology. Type C connector, type USB A connector. So that's how you define what is it. So here also terminology is very important. You cannot bring something outside. When you are talking to client or your consultants or your contractor, you have to talk in a particular fashion. Then only they will understand. So single stack system, as I explained, everything is connected to one shaft. What are the key features of the single stack system? So there are two types of joints. One is swept till ball socket joint or this aerator particularly. So what is the advantage? Stack aerator is a fitting in the stack, facilitates branch connection. So what it helps, you can see 100 mm dia or somebody may say 110 mm dia, three connections, 1, 2 and 3. Then 75 mm, three connections, 1, 2 and 3. So this one fitting allows you or helps you to connect with three WCs at one time. Now usually at a home there is only one WC in a toilet. So this helps if the architectural design is so suitable and it is, let us say, back to back toilets or side by side toilets, then you these type of fittings are very much useful because it helps to reduce the number of swept T's or Y, double Y. And one fitting helps you to give a proper drainage to that apartment. How is the flow? As we all know, the flow of the water, how it flows? It sticks to the wall of the pipe. Okay? Usually there is a air gap. How? I'll explain you. At the childhood, we have played all one small game. We had a tube, you fill it with water and put a thumb on that. So what happens? Water does not go out because there is a there is no air which allows. If you remove your thumb, the water will go out. Okay, water will get drained off because there is a air. So there is a proportion of air with water is very important in the drainage. That's why venting is very important. So it is a misconception that vent is allowing the air to go. No, it is allowing the water to suck in, so that your flow or flush things or drainage can go to the drains. So this is one of the modern techniques that in the single stack system this is used only. This is called as aerator, solvent, based on different product manufacturers, there is a different name. This is a general toilet layout where you can see there is a one stack which is connected to WC plus multi-floor trap coming out from the, so multi-floor trap will collect the water which is splashed out over here and from the wash basin that will go to the single stack. So this is called as the toilet with single stack drainage system. Right? Typical stack aerator section. This is the way aerators are installed. As I told you that the one pipe will come which will have multiple connections from bathtub, wash basin, bidet and WC which is connecting to the aerator or solvent, and then it is going to the horizontal drain. Now usually it is a practice that last toilet of the building or bottommost toilet of the building has to be connected separately so that the hydraulic jump which is forming in this region does not impact this toilet's operation. Otherwise what will happen? This trap seal will get blown away. Okay? Even if your building is 4-storied, even if your building is 400-storied, you will face the problem in the WC that trap seal is most of the time it is making noise, it is going away, you have to fill the water again and again, it is smelling badly or water coming inside. So this is the topic. If probably next sessions I get time, I will explain you. Then materials. So one thing you guys need to understand that industry is mostly driven by the manufacturers. Now why manufacturers? Manufacturers are the people who understand the market requirement and they understand the codal requirement. They amalgamate both and they manufacture the pipe. So you cannot find the pipe of 125mm dia easily in the drainage. Why? Because probably in the earlier time it is the requirement may be very small. So they are not manufacturing 125mm dia pipe. So you have to understand what are the materials of construction. Usually it is called as MOC. So there can be n number of materials available, but what are good for plumbing, that we will see. So material of the drainage pipe, this is the code you have to memorize because it might come into the quiz competition. Then RCC pipes are there with sulfate resistant cement, UPVC, unplasticized polyvinyl chloride shall be permitted for the underground. So there are several segregations. There are several segregations where to use what pipe. So there could be the glass pipe. Can we put it for the underground use? No, we will not put it for the underground. So there are the different materials, ABS, brass, cast iron, co-extruded, copper, GI, polyethylene, UPVC, SS304316, vitrified clay. And the use, whether it is to be used underground, above ground and inside the building. Okay, so based on the property of the material, abrasion, its impact load carrying capacity, the material is used either in the underground or inside the shaft. So the when you install the pipe underground, the pipe material has to undertake the load of abrasion. Abrasion means if a vehicle is moving above, it will create the vibration. Okay, so that it has to counter. Some it has to have some flexibility and some rigidity. Where because of the load it should not fail. Okay, but it should serve its purpose also at same time. This you need to memorize one thing. No GI, wrought iron or galvanized steel pipe shall be used in the drainage application. So due to the possibility of wrought iron or steel rusting. So it is common. See. whatever sewage is there, it is foul in nature. It generates H2S gas, it might be acidic, alkaline, okay, we through the oils, soaps, many things in the sewage. So, based on that, the water changes its property to either acidic or alkaline, which impacts the property of the pipe. If the pipe is not enough capable to withstand, what will happen? It will get erosion, maybe holes or washed away, there can anything can happen to that. So this terminology again you guys memorize, DWV, drainage waste vent. So short form, we will use it multiple times here on. ABS and UPVC, drainage waste and vent. Used above and below ground, used depend upon the building type. So this is the type of installations you can see at multiple sites. I would advise that you have already enrolled for this course, so better you visit the few construction sites. Okay, there are, I can see few people are from the construction sites also. Make friendship with them and go to the site and see how the installation is done. Plastic drainage waste vent fittings. Now, there are several fittings. A good manufacturer known by the fitting he manufactures, not the pipe. Pipe can be manufactured by anyone, but fittings are very important. Why so? Because if you don't get a particular fitting, how you will connect? Let us say there are two toilets side by side. How you will connect the vent? So you need this type of arrangement for that. Double wire, which will connect. This is inversely connected, so Y will be like this, and drainage will come, it will go to the drain pipe, vent will be here like this. Another toilet coming, going down shaft, and vent will be connected like this. So multiple fittings and type of fittings are also important. Some manufacture with rubber ring, some manufacture with solvent cement. Solvent cement is a glue kind of thing which is applied to the fittings and the pipe, and then it gets connected. Then there are clay pipe. These are quite old type of pipes, and if you go to the tier 3 or 4 cities, you can still see it is the socket and spigot type of joint, and usually filled with the cementing agents, and then the length is created to drain off, usually used in the external areas from cash, IC to IC or manhole to manhole. But this is very old type of technique. Nowadays hardly Mumbai, so I don't think anyone is using this type of pipe. But yes, as a technical person in this field, you should be aware that it is a saying, na, ke history repeats. Why? Because we don't learn from the history. So again, somebody after 15 years, 20 years, somebody say, I will make a clay pipe because they are more sustainable. Nowadays, there is a concept of sustainability. So rather than going for that, we can learn the problem. It was a very highly brittle type of pipe which gets easily damaged because of any abrasion load. Then SS pipe. There are two types, three types, SS304, 316 and 316L. So 304 is usually permitted for the above ground applications, and 316 is usually permitted to the below ground applications. Why? Simple. It is the ability for the corrosive resistance when it comes in touch with soil, the liquid flowing through it, many things. Cast iron pipe, this is the lead clog joint, particularly called as socket and spigot joint, as we seen here earlier also. But filling is different, here filling is different. They put the lead or something over here and make the robust joint. One of the robust joint in the piping industry in the ancient times was this lead clog joint for the cast iron pipes. Then, because it is very difficult, because you need the molten lead, it is toxic, the fumes are carcinogenic, what you need, somebody has to invent the new type of joint. So this is the this is hubless pipe. So this is hubless, means this is called as hub particularly. What is the hub? Hub allows to get the other pipe in and make a waterproof joint, watertight joint, and this is hubless. So two same dia pipe comes, there is no need of the hub, and you can connect with this rubber gasket covered with the jib clamp, and there is a screw to tighten. Now for the small diameters it is good, but when it comes to the 900,000 mm diameter, you need to test it after installation. Anything has to be tested, but this has to be tested more stringently. This is the particular installation of the hubless joints. You can see multiple joints. Again, drainage fitting shall be of cast iron, malleable iron, RCC, brass, copper, ABS, UPVC, PE, vitrified clay, SS 304313. Since the start of the era of plastic pipe, I would say that 90% of the non-plastic pipe has been vanished. Even you can say that sand pipes, sand blasted pipes, or even SS pipes, they are, SS pipe is coming up nowadays, but old type of technique, socket and spigot type of joints are getting vanished because of the ease of installation. Second, the material wastage. Now as the country is growing, you know, so much construction is going on, and we are hungry for the materials. Materials are not very easy to get. So what is happening? We have to find the material which has less wastage. So plastic has less wastage compared, because you can cut precisely wherever you want. Earlier days when there used to be the RCC pipe, nowadays also RCC pipe is used for the many infra projects, but can we cut it that easily? Plus it is a socket spigot type of joint, so what we would do with that cut portion? If you can utilize, good. If you can't utilize, it's a wastage. And RCC pipe is not easy to manufacture. Sometimes you go and see the manufacturing process, you will realize, okay, this is a huge manufacturing process and wasting is a crime for that. So this type of pipes are used. When the projects are very high end, like I have worked on early 360s where very high end specifications was there. So water supply pipe was of SS304. If you talk about Italia, then the drainage pipe is of SS316, I am not sure, but it is SS. Why SS? It gives more hygiene. It does not, even if you, when you talk, when we see the roughness, okay, when we see the roughness of pipe, SS is more finer than plastic. There is a theory called as Prandtl boundary layer theory. You can write it down. The name of the scientist is Prandtl. So Prandtl's boundary layer theory, and based on that theory, many K factors are derived for the friction. Okay, and there you can Google, or maybe there is a video on YouTube which you can see, that will tell you how, although we see it is a smooth surface, it is always like a zigzag line. But how smooth is that zigzag line defines the again smoothness. So different pipe has different smoothness. Other approved materials having smooth interior waterways of the diameter in the piping surface. So what is the basic, this slide is trying to tell you is, pipe has to be smooth surface. There should not be any choking, clogging, because of, there could be other several factors. Let us say we have not provided a right slope. Because of that, what is happening, there is a tendency of the soil material to get deposited and try to obstruct the flow. But at least pipe should not contribute to the choking up. So that's why it has to be smooth surface. Then fixture units. This is again an important criteria for all of you to note. In water it is called as water supply fixture unit, WSFU, whereas in drainage it is called as drainage fixture units, DFU. Here comes the design part. So whatever we till now we discussed is the most of the materials and typology. Now here comes the design part. There is a table 702.28 which you can refer, and you can get this table where the fixture unit is defined. So So what we have, I will not get into the details, but I will tell you the technicality behind it. What is the use of DFU or what is the use of friction unit? The use of friction unit is to identify the flow. How much flow is going to come in that pipe is very important, because based on that only you will size it. Okay. So I think first session was from Gabriel. They also have a particular carrying capacity. What is the carrying capacity? That is the maximum allowable flow. Otherwise, it will not function properly. Once you cross the maximum allowable flow, you need to add one more pipe. Okay. So this DFU calculation is very important. We are not going to get into the DFU calculations here, but understand the basic scenario of DFU. There are two types based on which you can define the DFUs. One is what is the outlet size. So let me go to the next slide. So here there are various fixtures which drains off, and you have the discharge fixture unit for public, private, private, public and assembly buildings. Now in the world there could be several other fixtures, and trust me, either you go to NBC, you go to ASP, you go to any Deva standards, you will not find all the fixtures covered in one code. Why so? Because fixtures are increasing. Rain shower is a quite recent era development. Earlier that was not there. So how you can define the flow of that drainage fixture based on the rain shower? Okay, we are just putting the shower hose in our home, but nowadays if you see South Mumbai homes or even this Dadar side home, they have rain shower, huge flow. Pressure is also very high. So no code has a comprehensive list, but yes, all codes tries to list out the discharge fixture units based on their understanding. So this is the complete list, you can find it in the code. What is here? The reason why I told you that there are no fixtures available, all fixtures are not available. So if sometimes you came across particular fixture which is not available, but the product manufacturer says that this fixture must be installed with the 40 mm outlet drainage dial. Drain pipe has to be 40 mm. So what could be the DFU? 3 units. If particular manufacturer says no, my fixture has to be installed with the 100 mm dia only, then 8 units of DFU. Okay. And this is one criteria of fixture unit, this is another criteria of fixture unit. This is based on fixtures, this is based on the outlet diameter of the fixture. Drainage fixture units for intermittent flow into the drainage system shall be computed on the rated discharge capacity. In this table you can find. So sometimes the flow is not continuous, flow is intermittent. Maybe like you can say, I am giving an example that is not true, but an example like theaters. Theaters have a very intermittent but very aggressive flow. When there is a intermission, everybody goes for the toilet and the flow is huge. That can be called as intermittent flow. However, as I said, it is not the truth. That can get covered in the public areas for the multiplex. But if similar building is there, something which is new type of building, you are constructing a particular footfall which is intermittent, then you can say. Emergency use of flow drains. So when we have the three compartment sink, or when there is a sink which is directly connected to the waste pipe, it is always advisable that you have a emergency flow drain. Why? Because there is a chances that one of them will leak or one of them will get crack, and you have to clean out the flow. So emergency flow drain is a very important criteria. So floor sink, this type of sinks are there which provides you the jali, you can easily cover it, clean it. Kitchen sink, roughly. So these are kitchen sinks have minimum 40 mm trap and shall have the drain into 50 mm drain. So what is the 40 mm trap? The trap seal. This is called as track seal. Track seal is defined by the various manufacturers based on their research. They carry out the research that how much should be the trap depth so that the foul gas should not flow, should not travel backward. Sizing example. So closed washer in group of three more than shall be rated at 6 unit each for the purpose of sizing common horizontal and vertical waste piping. Okay. So this you can check it by yourself because this is quite in detail and you can you will have this presentation. Maximum unit loading and maximum length of drainage and vent pipe size. As I said, there is a criteria for vent pipe sizing based on the fixture units. So these are the criteria given. Also, this is the length given. Drainage piping vertical and horizontal. Horizontal is unlimited, but vertical is defined in this room. Explanation of note 4 in the table 703. Only 4 WC 6 unit traps on 75 mm vertical pipe. Now here I am going to ask the question. So please be attentive. Top WC lavatory, they are connected to 75 mm pipe. This is 75 mm pipe going ahead. Then vertical stack of 75 mm pipe. Then 100 mm dia pipe. Can anybody tell what is the incorrect over here?
Vertical pipe.
Okay, somebody said, what's your question?
Niket
said vertical should be 100 mm. Any other?
Normally WC comes with the 90 mm object, so it has to be 100 mm.
Okay, right. Then why it is shown 75? Presentation में तो mistake नहीं करेंगे.
They have taken that depends on the unit.
Say.
Sir, there in note mentioned only 3 WC or 6 fixture units are permitted. But here 1, 2.
Irrespective of fixture units, we all know what should be the dia of WC output. Now, next slides, you will come to know why it is 75 and why it has to be 100. Only 3 WC is 6 units of 75 mm horizontal pipe. In India, most authority having jurisdiction require the minimum size of soil pipe as 110 and waste pipe of 75 while referring to the next. Because authority having jurisdiction has already defined that the dia of outlet has to be 100, that's why it is 100. Technically, based on fixture unit, mathematical calculations, you can define 75. So this calculation, so now you understand the reason. Explanation of note 5, based on the 1:100 grade, when 1:200 grade is used, the fixture unit amount of the appropriate column is multiplied by 0.8. Okay, these are the calculations part. Then check out fixture connection for single fixture units and SWFT. Now this SWFT is my personal favorite. When there is an aerator, which we saw on the first slide, there are several research laboratories and they have concluded that the SWFTs are nearly 90% efficient to the aerators or solvent joints. SWFTs are 90% efficient, means the efficiency is 90%. Only 10% more efficiency is there with aerators. Now, why solvent or aerator and why not SWFT? Although I like it personally. If it is a single toilet coming out, SWFT is advisable because you can only connect one connection. Again, few manufacturers like Gabrit and all, they have come up with ball socket joint where you can connect 3 connections. On the very first slide, we saw 6 connections, 3 of 100, 3 of 75 in ball socket you can connect either 300 or either two number, either three numbers of 75. Okay, so when you have a very optimized toilet positioning, like back-to-back toilets, side-by-side toilets, okay, then it is advisable that you go with this type of fitting. So Swifties are easy to install. I will correct my personal favorite, Swiftie with door fitting. Although hardly anyone uses the door fitting, door fitting is just a cap. And that cap can be removed and it can be cleaned easily. Sanitary Swifty double fixture. So as I said, a good manufacturer is defined by the number of fittings he produces. Fixture connections, this you can see. Typical commercial kitchen arrangement. Now as already we discussed, this is lead clock joint. So socket spigot joint for cast iron pipe, as we discussed earlier. You can see this socket, the pipe goes in and then the lead groove is poured, hot lead. So very dangerous to install, but a very good kind of joint. This is transition coupling, changes in the direction of lead. So whenever the spread pipe is changed in any direction, in simple words, it is called as change in direction. Whenever there is a change in direction, two things we have to do. If it is infra, try to install the manhole. If it is building, try to install the clean out plug. So clean out plugs, each clean out fittings for cast iron pipe shall be consist of cast iron or brass body. So this is theoretical. So clean out plugs are very important, because if you don't provide them, it is very difficult to maintain. And nowadays nobody over sitting over here is designing a bungalow project. In bungalow you can skip it, but those all of you are designing or executing the very high end projects, large area projects, minimum size clean out. So these are the type of clean outs, threaded type, various type of clean outs. You can get this fitting also. If you just missed, this is the clean out where this threaded part is installed here, but by some ways you missed or it is got stolen, then you can bring another one. This is the way you can install the clean out so that the rodding, the rod can get inside and clean the things. Now distance between two clean out is also important, because as I said, again we are designing a very high area project. The maximum length of the rodding eye you have is the distance between two clean outs. So clean out requirement, what is it? So you can see the clean out over here. Another type of clean out. This is the general arrangement of clean out. It has to be in the 45 degree arrangement so that the rodding eye can get inserted. Grade of horizontal drainage pipe. Horizontal drainage pipe 100 mm dia and smaller shall be installed in the practical alignment. So if the pipe diameter is 100 or less than 100, then 1 to 50 slope need to be maintained. If the dia is 100, then 1 in 100 or 150, sorry, for 150 dia, 1 in 100 slope. So if you go to the course, you will find more precise slopes are defined for higher diameters. So gravity drainage where practical as far as possible, all fixtures are shall be drained by gravity. There are two types of we have short time. I will try to speak loudly. There are two type of drainage. One is gravity, one is lift. In India, we don't believe in lift station. We don't believe in lifting station because of the power requirement, arrangement, availability, many things. So we mostly prefer the gravity. slopes. The gravities are usually in the slope as defined in the coder requirement. We can calculate the gravity slope of a pipe based on the volume of water, which is our volume of sewage getting inside to the pipe, but it is not permitted. You have to define the slope as per given in the codes only. This is one of the important product, which is backflow preventer. So usually this backflow preventer is installed before the municipal connection, municipal manhole drainage connection, so that the sewer inside the municipal should not get inside to the property. It just has a flat type arrangement which does not allow, which only allows the one way flow of the sewer. This is the flooding. When you don't have the backflow preventer, the things can get flooded. This type of arrangement is there. So this is the external manhole, which is above the, this is the basement probably. So you have fixtures in the basement. So let us say these are more fixtures. Let us say nowadays there are green building requirements that you must have one toilet for the drivers inside the basement. So what we will do that time, we will put the macerator pumps. There are some manufacturers who comes with this arrangement that if a particular single WC unit is there, it lifts the sewage and throws external. So macerator can be used. That's a particular thing. Below sewer, then this is the lifting arrangements. Sump pump installation. Sump pumps are always with one working, one standby. You are aware of that. There are several accessories like non-return valve, butterfly or ball valve, float for the dry run sensors. So different, this is the general arrangement. Nowadays it has gone quite ahead. There are many things installed in the, so these pumps are cutter type pumps. If it is sewage, as we are talking about sewage, then it might have 40 mm or 80 mm cutter capacity, solid cutting capacity. Usually these are SS pumps. Surge relief. Now this is one of the important topic. I will show this. What is surge? Surge is nothing but the jhaap. Marathi madhe jhaap and face point. So what happens? You might have seen most of the time when the sewage flows because of the detergent and everything. What happens? Surge are natural to get generated. Jhaap banega hi, your face jo hai to bane, because it's a detergent and sewage. Okay. So what happens when surge are there? It does not permit the drain to flow properly, and it has a property to expand. So what will happen if it expands? It will choke up your drainages. Okay. And if it choke up, then there is a problem. So there are surge reliefs are provided, which surge reliefs are provided. So this is the general arrangement, non-sudding stack and then sudding stack. So the surge, if it is, it will, it's just a buffer arrangement, nothing but a buffer arrangement, which allows the surge to rise in a particular stack. So there are calculations how to calculate the surge based on your type of uses, and you can define the diameter and the height of the sudding stacks. So testing, we will talk. The piping of the plumbing drainage venting system shall be tested with water, air, except the plastic pipe shall not be tested with air. There are various testing methods available across the world. There are smoke tests, there are water leakage tests, there are a number of tests. Some tests say 30 minute duration, some tests say 60 minutes, some tests say 24 hours duration. Okay. So, water test shall be applied to the drainage and venting system either by the entirely or in section with minimum 1800 mm head of water. So, 1.8 bar water for minimum 15 minutes. Although it is drainage, some test has to be there so that leakage will not be there. Smoke test, as I have said, in India it is not much popular because it requires some specific instruments which are, and that's not a practice, so not much use. But yes, in Middle East you can see smoke test is very popular for the vertical shaft. In India, smoke test is there for the horizontal piping. When you infrastructure pipes are laid, you can see they burn some coals and some smoky item and close all the manholes. And then the people run and they see if there is a particular leakage is there, they can, if the smoke is visible. Then there is a vapor test also, water test, and there is a vapor test also. Because it's a smoke, maybe toxic, intoxic. Intoxic smokes are very expensive to make. So there is a vapor test. Vapor test, what is there in the vapor test? The vapors of the water are generated and all the joints are observed whether there is any leakage. And it is with some particular color. Building sewers, large building complexes such as this need to be filled with external sewers. We have covered most of the things, but I will just touch base the important points. Sewer definition. So that part of the horizontal piping drainage system which extends from one from the end of the building drain 600 mm outside the building and receives the discharge from the building drain, conveys it to the public sewer, private sewage disposal system or the point of disposal. So, the sewer system or sewerage system, there is a specific meaning, you can Google it, even I forgot, for the sewer and sewerage. So, anything other than building is external sewer. We popularly call in a consultant's terminology, external. So public sewer system, individual connections, so you can see various connections are there and dedicated street is there, manholes are there where the connection is happening. It is mandatory to provide the manholes. You might see sometimes that manholes are given even after a meter or 2 meters or 3 meters. Technically it has to be after 20 meters. But why it is connected, why sometimes they are placed so near? Because there are many connections are coming over there. Private sewage disposal system, if public sewer is non-existent, then distribution box, septic tank, sorry, from building it comes to septic tank, then it goes to the distribution box and then some of the soak pits. Damage to the public sewer or private sewer system disposal, it shall be unacceptable for any person to deposit any ashes, solid, flammable, poisonous or explosive liquids and gases, oils, grease, etc. And nowadays, tissue papers, sanitary pads, everything. Please make sure and spread this awareness. I keep telling this to a lot of people. Avoid throwing such things in the sewer, they are bound to choke. Sizing of the building sewers, the table is available. You can see how to size it based on the, as now we earlier also spoke, the slopes. So this is the 1 in 200. Generally, there is a tendency to talk in terms of percentage. Where is 1% slope, 2% slope, 3% slope. So 1% is 1 in 100, 2% is 1 in 50. It is just a ratio. Construction of manhole. So this type of manhole construction is there. This is called as benching. This is the pipe, half pipe arrangement is there. This is made up of RCC. There are various sizes. This is again a benching, it is created here. You can see slope is created so that the sewage should flow properly. Stepped manhole, tapering manhole. Sewer and water pipes. Bottom of the water pipe created above the sewer. So, water pipes should always be above the sewer lines. That is the common practice, it is also there in the codes. Water line crossing 300 mm shall be above. Protection of the building sewers. Building sewers pipe shall be laid on the firm bed throughout the entire length. And such pipe laid in the bed filled with ground shall be laid on the bed of approved material. So the soil material, whatever it is there, it has to be compacted properly to the MDD level 5. That's a compaction grade. So so that the layer can be created, on that you can lay the pipe. Separation of the sewer and water lines, as I said, sewer, and there has to be the difference. This is based on code. This 300 is based on code. Location, building structures away from 600 mm, property of the adjoining clear, means from the building property it has to be clear, it should not clash with the building property. Water supply, wells, streams, what should be the distance between the sewer lines and the good water sources. Building sewer test, so there will be again various tests to be conducted. Sewer sizing, these are the tables given where you can size the sewers based on various fixture units. Preamble, in this absence of municipal sewer system in most of the part of India, property owners often required to construct own sewer network leading to on-site treatment. So, treatment plant, septic tank is an old school thing, but treatment plant need to be installed. Some capacity, now as we spoke about the lifting stations, so lifting stations, how you will calculate the size of lifting station based on the flow it is coming, it is contributing to. So that flow need to be calculated based on discharge fixture units, and you can calculate the sump capacity based on that peak flow. You can define the pump capacity also. Most of the manufacturers take the fixture units from you, discharge fixture units, and then they define the, they give you the ready-made product. Now salient fixtures, DFUs, as I said, water supply fixture units and DFU, discharge units, drainage units are different. Do not consider wash basin ke liye yahan pe ek hai, toh wahan pe bhi ek hoga. No, it is not like that. Calculate the flow into the pump section terms of water supply fixture unit based on table 6.9 from UIPC. Sewerage pumping stations. These are the some detailed drawings. You need to learn these ones or memorize these ones. Bypass connections in the drain. In sudden rise and drop in the loop must be avoided along the route of the pump discharge. So there has to be bypass. We usually provide that. Screen chamber or wall chamber. In order to prevent large objects such as clothes, sanitary napkins, racks, etc. entering in the sewage, the gravity drain to the sump shall be connected through a screen chamber. So this is the presentation. Sorry, I have to wrap up because we are running short of time, and I don't have time for questions. But I am available. Yeah.